Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Ramesh Kumar, AVP-O&M of Amplus Solar. Amplus, to give just an introduction to the people who are new to the solar rooftop industry. Amplus is one of the major players in the solar rooftop sector with above 100 plants already installed, operational. And we're also doing ground mount projects of around 50 to 60 megawatt of installed capacity we already have, and we are doing a project of 175 megawatt peak in the state of Karnataka under open access model, which is probably the biggest site in India under open access. Now I am here today to discuss about the challenges in O&M of rooftop solar. Before I start, I would like to request the audience to consider the solar rooftop industry because it is relatively younger compared to the solar ground mounts. So some of the things that may look very basic to you, but I would like to touch upon the basics of O&M only in my presentation of solar rooftops. There is an interesting question before starting this. What is the O&M cost per megawatt of a rooftop solar power plant? If someone can give me a number for it. That is an interesting question. Well, there is no specific answer, as you have, many of you know, that can vary from somewhere around 4 lakh rupee megawatt to as high as 20 lakh rupee per megawatt. It is basically because of two main reasons, which is the size and location of the plant. Depending on the size and location of the plant, how the cost can vary. Just to illustrate, I have taken two examples. To the right, I have provided 1 megawatt of capacity spread across 5 200 kilowatt peak sites. And I am assuming that each site is managed by a dedicated resource, and the cost, O&M cost, is coming to around 33% of the revenue that the project can generate. So it clearly rules out a possibility of keeping a dedicated resource at each of the solar power plants in rooftop. And to the left is a case where 3 megawatt of capacity spread across 15 sites of the same capacity again is managed by a single resource like engineer or technician. And the cost will be dropping down to 7 lakh rupee per megawatt, which is still higher considering the present day, you know, targets that are being set, because it is always compared to the ground mount solar. So we now know that it is not possible to manage the site with dedicated resources, and we have to keep multiple, we have to load as many sites possible on each of the engineers that we have. So probably around 20 to 25 sites loading on one engineer or technician is what we are looking about. So how to do it? We are doing it in two ways at Amplus. We monitor all the plants from remotely, a centralized location, which we call it as a remote operation center, ROC, which basically continuously communicates and coordinates with the site engineers. They do the analysis in case of performance lapses, and they inform this performance deviations to the site engineers to respond quickly. And second part of it is the automation. Automation in Amplus, what we have done to reduce the downtime of the plants, we have given an SMS alert based system to the site engineers. An SMS is generated in case of any breakdown of the plant, and the plant is not getting restored within a 15 to 20 minutes time, so that the engineer knows which site he has to visit today. The other part is to optimize the resources. Yes, if you want to load more sites on a single engineer, like 20 to 25 sites when we are speaking in a geography of say around 150 to 250 kilometers spread, we need to invariably enable the site engineers with the technology. We've already given the tabs to each of our O&M engineers who are visiting site. And all the preventive maintenance and breakdown maintenance, we have inbuilt checklist into the tab. And photographs also can be captured and uploaded into the ERP system of the company instantaneously. That's what we have done. And second important thing is the standardization. If we want to reduce the O&M cost and increase the number of sites on a single engineer, it is important to have standardization of systems and processes. At Amplus, we do like O&M plan for the complete year, one full year covering all the plants under operation, and we give it to the site engineers along with the resource allocation plan. This actually reduces the O&M cost to a significant extent. Of course, execution of the plan is very important. Any plan without proper execution is of no use. Third most important thing when it comes to the rooftop sector is the documentation part. In my personal opinion, we in rooftop segment were severely lacking in the documentation part. This documentation could actually help us save millions of rupees when we are talking about a 40,000 megawatt capacity of installed capacity in India. So what we do basically using the documentation is that we want to isolate the site from a particular engineer or the technician. Irrespective of who is visiting the site, even for the first time, he should be able to address the issue properly, troubleshoot the problems and bring back the site into operation. That is very important. If you follow a proper documentation procedure, then anyone can understand the history of any problem and then immediately attend the problem. That's the essence of it. And next advantage of documentation is that we are feeding it back to the engineering team and the construction team, whatever observations we have during the O&M, so that in our future projects, the same mistakes are not getting repeated. The third advantage is, because of the geographical spread of the site, spare parts management is very difficult in solar rooftops. Particularly, you cannot decide on the volume of the space and the cost of the space, and particularly the location of the space where you need to keep. So in order to overcome this challenge, you need to have at least data of 1 or 2 years operation. Along with proper documentation, we are in a better shape to position to actually optimize the spare parts cost. Other challenges are mainly related to the client. When I say client related issues, one of the major issues is the load variability of the client. Particularly on public holidays, what we have seen is that because the client's load drops to a minimum or zero, we are forced to stop our plant. That is one case. The other case is whenever they are carrying out a preventive maintenance on their electrical system or their plant machinery itself, we have been ordered to curtail the solar power plant, causing us a generation loss. Third major issue is when we are doing a regular O&M activity like cleaning or the preventive maintenance. This happens with the reputed clients because they have their own internal systems and processes in place. In order to comply with their protocols, we sometimes have to waste our resources for a half a day or a full day. And it actually puts pressure on the tightly managed resource plan of the rooftop solar O&M team. In order to overcome this, what we are doing is that at the time of PPA with the clients, we have to be very clear on the scope on what we are going to do. Because some of the clients, it is very nature of the clients that, you know, anything that happens on the roof is a problem of rooftop solar company, irrespective of whether they are directly responsible for it or not. So that needs to be clearly stated in the agreements. The other part is there should be a deemed generation clause in each and every agreement. Of course, it has a limited use. I cannot go back to the client every day and ask for a deemed generation. But in extreme cases where my generation loss extends beyond a week or so, I'm actually covered by the deemed generation clause of the agreement. And vendor management. Vendor management, again, particularly with respect to this cleaning of the solar modules, it is difficult to find professional vendors in remote areas of the country. Even if you get a reputed vendor to work for you on a rooftop solar cleaning, he in turn gives it to a local vendor. Again, the same problem continues on the quality of cleaning as well as the safety of the personnel working at site. The solution that we have found out for this is to gradually try and identify right people in the remote areas also. Each zone we have to develop certain number of vendors who can do the module cleaning in a professional way. We only bear the training cost so that maybe 1 year or 2 years down the line, we'll have enough number of O&M solar panel cleaning companies available in remote areas of the country. Third major area is spare parts management. Again, as I discussed earlier, spare parts management is very difficult because of the nature of the business, remoteness of the sites. It is very difficult to challenging to optimize the spare part cost or the volume. And even I'm not certain where to keep my space is a major challenge. With proper documentation, we are trying to avoid this with 1 or 2 years operational data. I think we have 40 of our sites which are operating for more than one and a half year now. So we are relatively in a better equipped with the data to decide on how much space are to be kept where. And major area that personally I feel in rooftop solar is the safety. In ground mount solar, because you have the luxury of having at least 4 to 5 people in the site, people always work in tandem, which is called a buddy pair popularly. Buddy pair avoids many of the safety incidents. In case of any accident, you have people to respond immediately. But in case of rooftop solar, because the person is traveling alone and the person is working alone on the solar rooftop, you never know what happens to the person who is visiting the site. So we have introduced a system called on-call buddy pair in coordination with the ROC team. The person who is visiting the site is talking to the ROC, and ROC is in turn connecting with some other person who is available for a call every now and then. And the second person will be calling the first person continuously after every 1 hour to check whether he is safe or not. This is one system that we could introduce, because we cannot, when we talk about 25 sites to a single person, I cannot have the luxury of keeping a second person only because I want safety. And other things are like work permit system we have introduced for our vendors, for our engineers. Invariably, any activity that they do on any premise, he has to take a work permit from the HOD. That's a system that we have implemented. And we are also on course to implement all the systems that are prevailing in any standard industry in rooftop also, like providing the electrical rubber mats, fire extinguishers, electrical gloves, and all the PPEs to the site engineers who are working on site, including the cleaning labor.
Can I just conclude?
Yes. Finally, this is my favorite quote when it comes to the O&M. The secret of success is to do the common thing uncommonly well. Even if you are doing the same thing for 10,000 times, we have to do it with the same level of quality and consistency. Thank you very much for patient listening.